Uwchan ASMR. As you can see, it's nothing majorly wrong with this doll. However, her eyebrows have completely faded away. Her lashes aren't perfect. If you take this off, her hair isn't even. I don't know if when I was younger I decided to cut this baby's hair or what, but it ain't it. So we're gonna fix her. We're gonna give her a scalp massage. I have my adhesive spray, which I'm going to use to put these eyelashes on. I have some paint, which I'm going to mix with the black paint to make her some neutral colored eyebrows. I might even change her lip color to something more brighter, naturally done. But let's go ahead and get this back in. And you're gonna need a very little bit of black. Oh, that's too much. Let me do this. So you guys can see. Oh, this one isn't open. You know what, I'm gonna use a darker brown. Use that. And mix it with some blonde. Oh, yes, that's a lot, I'm aware. But you'll see. Now that that's mixed, come in with that to brighten it and get more of a brown tint to it. Yes, I got paint on my hands. I also got blue paint up here. So my fingers are getting stained, but that's okay. So I was in the middle of recording this video maybe 20 minutes ago, and my camera completely failed. I was recording on a different phone, which has way more space than the one I'm recording on now. But for some reason, the camera just kept crashing. So I had to, restart over, which sucks because I had to start working on the doll's eyebrows. Not eyebrows, eyelashes and everything, but you know, it's okay. This video should turn out better. So, got a measurement. Now this, if you're wondering, it's a watercolor paintbrush. So you open it and you put your water in it. It's very convenient, actually. It's very convenient. However, I'm not gonna put any water in it. We're gonna set this aside. And we're gonna place you here. We're gonna get our mask. Oh. It kind of swallows her. Just a little bit. We're gonna get our ruler. And we're gonna mark the starting point for the eyebrows. So right at all. It'll look better once we're done, don't worry. So, coming in with this brush. Gotta get it right in the exact spot and press down, 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 press down. We don't want to pull that right up. We want it to stay till it dries. I come in with my paper tape. Go up gently. I'm gonna come in with my eyeliner. As you can see, I'm just darkening the natural black line they got on her eyes to make it more visible. I don't know if you can see the difference on camera from this one to this one, but it's a difference in person. Using pinky to lift. And it's completely okay if mistakes like that is made, because I have acetone, which I can easily get it off. Now, this should be dry. Yes, it's dry. Now you're gonna have this be a kind of a problem, and I say kind of because I'm gonna come in with adhesive spray. If it wasn't stuck, I would have sprayed it, but it's stuck. So I'm gonna come in with this just like this. I'm gonna come in with this. Why do I want that paper to stay stuck on your USC? Okay. Yes, her eyebrows are looking like. Okay. Okay, so what we got to work with right now is a lip pencil in the shade Plum. I'm gonna come in with this. I'm gonna do this. So hopefully YouTube lets me cut that out. I kind of dropped my phone. If YouTube let me cut that part out, then I'm letting you guys know right now I dropped my phone, which is why it's abruptly interrupted like that. I'm coming in with a black eye pencil right now. And some people might get triggered that her eyebrows isn't necessarily on fleek. I'm doing it this way solely because this doll is in representation of a baby, no more than 3 years old. So, what 3-year-olds wears makeup? I know there's some on Instagram and honestly wanna their parents, but can't be doing that. So. I'm gonna come in and wipe off this paintbrush I use. We don't want any paint on it. We want it to be just like that. No paint coming off. And I'm going to smooth it out a little bit. Just a bit. Just a bit. I want it to have that smudge effect before I come in with my Q-tip to straighten it. You may be wondering why I use the ruby on the bottom of the black. It's because I wanted it to have more of a brown feel to it than black. So we're gonna spray that with some finishing spray. Gonna come in and do. Am I still recording? Yes, okay. Now I'm gonna come in with the eyelashes. I want to curl her eyelashes, but I think her face is too steep for me to use it. Yeah, it is. Okay. So, ouch. We got this bad boy. I'm gonna plug her up. Turn it on. And we're going to size the eyelashes. So this side is more on fleek than this one, so I'm going to use the fuller one on this eyelash, on this eye, and then use the this one, yeah, on that one. Let me curl it. Okay, then I'm gonna trim it. Is as hot as it going to get, as hot as we're gonna need it to get for this. Just gonna, ooh, is it burning? Is it burning? I think it's burning. It is burning, but that's okay. We kind of want them to stick together. Yeah, that's good enough. Okay. So I'm gonna come in with the adhesive spray. I'm gonna open one eyeball. I'm gonna put this adhesive spray right on the edges, how you would do your normal eyelashes with eyelash glue. Except this is adhesive spray on a baby doll. So, I think I lost my other eyelash. I did. I lost the other. Oh no, there it is. Okay. So, we're gonna come in. To use my tweezers, however, they're not in my makeup kit for some reason. So we gotta do this bad boy by hand. So ooh. let me just tell you right now, this is a lot harder than putting it on and putting on your actual eyelashes. Okay, so I know what I'm gonna have to do. And I am not going to like it. We trimmed off a fine line there, which is highly annoying, but I'm gonna come in with this adhesive again. Mazda gonna come in with some actual glue. Ooh, that's too much. That's too much. Okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, that should be fine, right? So. We're gonna just eat and move them down. Ooh. Okay, now I'm gonna come in with something that's not gonna stick to, which is my scissors, and push it down off of my hand, and put it on that, do a little bit of this, and a little bit of that, and a little bit of this. Perfect. That's so bad, oh my god. We're gonna let it dry, of course. Oh, I grabbed the one that had the paint on it. Okay, so. Oh, good. Okay. So, now I'm going to come in. I think curling it first is what messed me up. So I'm gonna try not to curl it. And just stick it on. So, actually maybe I can just stick it. So I'm gonna try to just stick it in with the. Oh, where'd it go? Where'd it go? I really don't see it this time, you guys. Well, I still have this from the other eyelash. So we're gonna I don't think sticking it in is gonna work. Instead of putting the glue onto the doll, I'm gonna put it onto the eyelash. Like so. Okay, that worked. I don't know why I didn't do that at first. See, I have naturally curled lashes, so whenever I put on falsies, which is fake eyelashes for some of y'all that don't know, I have to put the glue onto my eyelid instead of the eyelashes. So when I was doing it to the doll, I did it how I'm used to do it, but apparently just doing it the traditional way on the eyelash was the way to go. So all the cutting was unnecessary. However, I did find another piece that was from this eyelash, so we're gonna put that over there. Let me just put the glue on. I'm gonna fan it a little bit with my mouth. And then I'm gonna place it. I'm trying to find my thingy. And yes, I'm aware that the eyelashes are a longer length than the doll's natural lashes. But that's what we got scissors for. Snip it. Snip it. And we want this to dry peacefully, so I'm gonna come back in with my tape. I've gotten at least 20 messages so far making this video, but on a normal day when I'm bored and not doing anything important, nobody messages me. So like, why is y'all messaging me now when I'm let it drop, come on, tape. Okay. Nice. Okay. So it's gonna take a while for those to dry, sadly. But we got more pressure issue with just this, so coming back in with the eyeliner. Gonna do the generic Baby Alive doll thing, which is this. But I'm gonna smudge it. Those are some bushy eyebrows. Bushy, bushy, bushy. Okay, now. thing about this is that we used an eyeliner pencil. So I'm pretty sure if I do that, it will come off. Joke's on you. That's why we put the paper down first. Now this one will come off because it wasn't not nearly as much paper as on this side. But that's okay. I'm just gonna fix it with now we're going to give this a little bit more time to dry. So while that is drying, let's fix up the water. You're going to want some black castor oil. Few drops, some peppermint oil, more than a few drops, and your water. This is what I use to help my hair grow. I also put jojoba oil in it. Give it a little shake. What I'm going to be using is this one. And this comb. And this for the scalp massage. I had her underneath my little dryer that's on, so that should be okay to go. As you can see, it's still some white, so it's not completely dry, but we have our mask that we're gonna put over these two. And we're going to get it in the back with one of these boys. And now her face is protected. Don't want anything to be smashed down because stuff is still drying. So that's good. Now let's move on to the scalp massage. First tool I'm going to be using is this. Thank you. than usual. I cannot find my microphone. I think my mom stole it, to be honest. And I had ordered a microphone off of eBay, but the seller turned out to be a fraud, and eBay gave me my money back today. So I had to look for a new mic to buy. What we're doing right now is combing our hair to the back so that we can cut it evenly. I don't know about you guys, but I personally love human scissor sounds. So we're gonna cut. And cut. Make sure you pull when you cut too, in terms of doll hair. Even with that, and about this side, she got a little bob going on now. Do you want her to have the bang going on? So we're going to get this and get this. Hold it as tight as you can so that you can make that knot, that hair pattern move forward. And now we're going to get our tape. Yes, the tape again. And leave this right at the root. Keep it down as we continue with the scalp massage. gonna come in and try it. I am moving a bit quicker because it seems like I've been recording over 20 minutes and I don't know how much space my phone has. So in case I stop abruptly, thank you for watching. This is just in case because I've had it happen a few times where my phone ran out of storage and the video stopped abruptly and I had to start all over. So, just giving y'all a warning because this is kind of too long to start over. So, just brushing this all to the back. And with it dried, you can see more arrows like that needed to be snipped, and that. Brush to the back, brush to the back, brush to the back. Hair is dry like this. Oh wait, this is a movie thing. Let's snip, 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 snip. When the hair is wet like this, is the perfect time to apply any kind of gels. If you want gels, that is. So I got my Argan Oil Color Wave Twist Shaping Gel. It smells lovely. You know how most hair gels stink? This smells divine. I know some people love those sounds, so I just wanted to incorporate it. So, I'm gonna add the gel to slip down these baby hairs, cause she's a baby doll, so she got baby hairs. Okay, we're shaping it to form like that. Gonna come in with my brush. Just brush it to be even slicker, even slicker, even slicker, even slicker. Now I'm just moving the bonnet closer, the headband closer to the back. Okay. that's about it. So I guess we're gonna get it. Oh. Take that off. Now the eyelashes should be dry. Ooh, yes, they're dry. Okay, as far as this, I'm just going to swoop it. Add some gel to the fingertips. Get those roots gelled up so that I can style this the way I want to style it. Get that in piece. And now, swoop it to the side. I've noticed that side swoops is a thing now. So I'm trying to incorporate anything anyone might like into this video. So we're just doing a little baby side swoop. We want it to be as flat as possible. It's as flat as possible. Come up with this brush to fit those ends. Nice. Okay, my hands is extremely sticky due to the gel. But that's okay. Now I'm coming back in with my ruby, not ruby, plum, onto the lips. I'm also gonna come in with this, which I haven't even tried on myself yet. Gonna come in with this to blend it. This is just to make her lips more vibrant. Okay, now I'm gonna just wipe off where I kinda got it to the sides. But I'm also gonna apply some over here and just rub it in with my fingers to make her cheeks more poppin'. Now, if you decide you want to fix up your old doll, remember that when doing the lips, it will be sticky if you use actual lipstick. So you can just spray it with hairspray. Yes, hairspray. Make sure to cover the eyebrows if you did the eyebrows, because they will run off. But spray with hairspray. And you'll have a nice slick feel to it. gonna cover her eyebrows and spray her with finishing spray that has gold specks in it, because we extra like that, to be honest. So we're gonna get the forehead too. Okay. Ooh, some hair got on you. Okay, let's put that behind the ear. Gonna open the eyes. Cut the false lashes if need be. Lightly brush them. And you got a pretty good baby alive, though. I mean, she was fine already, but I wanted to make sure she stayed looking fresh. What you can do is put on a stocking cap to ensure the hair dries the way you want it to dry. But yes, she is looking baby good. Please comment below if you have any video suggestions. This video was actually suggested. Well, the length of it was. Someone told me that they liked the hair brushing video, but they wished it was longer. I couldn't think of... I know I could have just did a full, like, strictly hair brushing video longer, but I wanted to incorporate something else because other people may enjoy too. I know a lot of people like hair brushing videos. I personally love them. But I wanted to add something different, you know. And I saw this old doll. I think I got her when I was 11 or 12. And so I was like, you know what, let's fix her up a little bit to make a video out of it. So if you guys enjoyed that, let me know. If you guys want more videos like this, sadly I don't have any more dolls that need any work on. But I can do my best to, like, buy any old dolls from a thrift store or something and fit them up for an ASMR video. However, your girl's broke. So, it may take me a while to do that. But yeah, if you enjoyed this, leave a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe for more content and comment for the algorithm, please. And yeah, have a great day. This is your host, Uwchan, speaking, and I'm heading out. Bye.